BDNF has been described as fertilizer for your brain, and it plays a key role in neuroplasticity, which makes your brain more resilient to stress and adaptable to change. Decreased levels of BDNF have been associated with various neurodegenerative disorders, such as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease and multiple sclerosis. It's also been linked to depression, eating disorders, obesity, and even suicidal behavior. While higher levels are associated with enhanced cognitive function, mental health, and memory. And as you can imagine, brain health is key to your mental health. So in this video, we're going to take a look at what BDNF is and how to increase it to optimize brain health and cognitive function. Hi, I'm Ben Angel, and I teach people how to biohack their way back to health. Before we dive in, hit like, subscribe, and click the link below to join thousands of others who've already downloaded my brand new book, Mind Control, to learn how to biohack their gut, mind, and mood. In the 1980s, researchers discovered a protein that encouraged the growth of new brain cells. They called it Brain-Derived Neurotrophic Factor, or BDNF for short. In numerous studies, BDNF has been shown to increase brain plasticity, ease depression, boost weight loss, improve sleep by increasing your slow brain waves during deep sleep while protecting you against neurodegenerative diseases. The question is, can we boost BDNF? Well, before we get to that, we have to first address what stops or slows the production of it. The top three offenders are stress, via the release of cortisol, which suspends its production, which means fewer new brain cells are formed. Age. Unfortunately, BDNF levels naturally decline with age. And sugar. Eating sugar has been shown to curb BDNF production. While the best ways to increase BDNF include, one, music. One study investigated the effect of music on the brain and BDNF production in mice. They found that the exposure to music can modulate the activity of the hippocampus by influencing BDNF production. Furthermore, in a study of the Department of Neurosciences and Mental Health in Italy, they found that BDNF levels are higher in people who practice music. Two, diet. In a study published in Nutritional Neuroscience, scientists from the University of Las Palmas de Gran Canaria in Spain studied the effects of the Mediterranean diet on BDNF levels in patients with major depression and ones without. They followed them over 3 years because dietary changes can take months to affect brain function. The patients with major depression had increased levels of BDNF, while those who weren't clinically depressed showed no changes in BDNF levels at all. What does this mean? Well, it means that if you're depressed, a Mediterranean diet might improve your moods. But if you're not, it's unlikely that anything will happen, although you will be healthier regardless. Intermittent fasting has also been shown to boost BDNF levels by 50 to 400%. It's also important to point out that there's a link between obesity and low BDNF. Three, deep sleep. BDNF is released during deep sleep, but due to chronic stress and modern lifestyle habits, such as an abundance of blue light from electrical devices, you may lack this key stage of sleep. Drop the room temperature at night, wear blue blockers, and yes, even try putting an ice pack on your forehead at night to help induce sleep. Four, prebiotics. Prebiotics are food for good bacteria to feed on. They also help to colonize healthy strains in the lower intestine. Fascinatingly, prebiotic foods have been found to promote BDNF production. These foods include asparagus, bananas, chocolate, garlic, onions, and tomatoes, to name just a few. Five, adaptogens. And this is a personal favorite of mine. It's ashwagandha. Ashwagandha has been shown to decrease levels of cortisol by up to 30% and helps to boost BDNF levels while also helping to prevent further decline of BDNF levels in the brain. However, this is one adaptogen that you need to avoid if you do have low blood pressure. And six, nootropics. In a research paper titled Behavioral and Molecular Evidence for Psychotropic Effects in L-theanine, researchers conclude that L-theanine has an antipsychotic-like and possibly antidepressant-like effect. It exerts these effects at least in part through the induction of BDNF in the hippocampus and the agonistic action of L-theanine on the NMDA receptor. Bottom line, BDNF not only helps to protect you from neurodegenerative diseases, it encourages the formation of new brain cells and protects existing ones. So if you'd love to learn more about BDNF and other tips on how to biohack your mind, body, and mood, be sure to download my latest book, Mind Control, from the link below. And if you're battling depression or anxiety, join me in the interactive workshop, The Biohacker's Guide to Dismantling Depression, where we're going to dig out the root causes and tackle them head on. Click the link below now because it's filling fast. Finally, hit like, subscribe, and drop me a comment by answering this question. What steps have you taken before to boost BDNF production? Share it in the comments below to help support one another. I'm Ben Angel, and I'll catch you next time. Take care.